Hi students, this is Ram Mohan, JL in History, Dormant Junior College, Kachiguda. In our first year history, the last chapter, National Movement, in that we have completed all movements of Mahatma Gandhi and revolutionary movements and the phases also. Now we are going to discuss the great leader and great freedom fighter and great extremist who sacrificed his life for India's freedom. So, it was none other than Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose. Okay, we call Netaji. He founded Azad Hind Fauj and started a great fight against the British. He did not believe, he did not follow Gandhi's ideology, but he respected Gandhiji ideology, Gandhiji weapons, but he did not take path. Okay. But his path is completely different. Okay. And that was violent way. And he wanted to take the support of other nations who are, those countries are enemies of England. Okay. So later, he started a great fight also after, okay, during the this Gandhiji movement also, he fought against the Britishers in different ways. So his party is the Forward Black. This was the result of the differences between Subhash Chandra Bose and Mahatma Gandhi. So Forward Black party or union was the a great result of the difference between Mahatma Gandhi and Subhash Chandra Bose. It was founded in 1939. So, in this, Subhash Chandra Bose took Second World War was an opportunity to fight against the Britishers. Because Britishers already weakened and they requested Indians to participate in Second World War. So, financially, they declined. The weekend, because already they did war in the First World War also. In Second World War, they weakened completely. So that it was a situation to give, compulsory situation already created here. So that they are ready to give. Okay, they are ready to give freedom to India. So ultimately, Subhash Chandra Bose decided here, because of the weakness of British rule here, He wanted to make friendship with other countries who are completely against of the England. So that he formed here Forward Black and started here fight against the Britishers. So while he was moving like this, the Britishers are suspicious. They grow suspicious of Subhash Chandra Bose. They interned him. However, Subhash Chandra Bose escaped and reached here Berlin. So, Germany capital city is Berlin. It was under the control of Hitler. So, Germany's dictator Hitler, he wanted to take the support of Germany, Japan and Italy. So that he escaped and reached Berlin. Bose reached here, later Tokyo also in 1943. And cordially received by Japanese Premier. Here, Subhash Chandra Bose gave a call, that is a Chalo Delhi, means to reach Delhi, to occupy Delhi, that is the slogan of Azad. He was very confident, okay, of Germany's support to India against the British. That's what he reached Berlin, and he wanted to take the support from Germany, okay, in India's freedom struggle. So that he recruited here people and trained the soldiers for any eventual war. However, on the eastern sector, during the Second World War, Japan emerged victorious and defeated Britain. Okay, they occupied here Singapore and marched towards India. Simultaneously, Ras Bihar Bose, Captain Mohan Singh, both revolutionaries here, raised an armed force, that is called here Indian National Army, INA. INA stands for Indian National Army, which was established by Ross Bihari Bose and Captain Mohan Singh. These two revolutionaries here established here INA. So they invited Subhash Chandra Bose to take up leaders, to lead the INA. Immediately, Subhash Chandra Bose accepted and became the president or chief of the commander of Azad Hind Fauj. So Azad Hind Fauj or INA, both are same. So first INA, when it was established, when he took up, Subhash Chandra Bose took up the charge of INA, it was named as Azad Hind Fauj. So Azad Hind Fauj or INA, both are same, established by two people here, Ras Bihari Bose and Mohan Singh. So when Subhash Chandra Bose escaped from India, reached Berlin, he took support from, he wanted to take the support from Germany also. So when Japan reached here, defeated here England and occupied Singapore and marched towards India. So these Singapore and other areas, which were the parts of India, hand over to INA also. This is Azad Hind Fauj. Chandra Bose reached Tokyo in 1943 and was cordially received by the Japanese premier. This onwards, Subhash Chandra Bose gave a call, that is a Chalo Delhi. The slogan of Azad Hind Fauj or Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose was Chalo Delhi. So that he wanted to take the help of Germany and Japan to fight against the Britishers in India. So to fight against the Britishers, he wanted to take help from Japan and Germany, because these two countries, these two forces completely against of Britishers. So that enemy's enemy is friend. So this policy is believed by Subhash Chandra Bose. That's what he wanted, to take the help of Germany and Japan. So there was a women's regiment in the INA too, that is known as the Jhansi Rani Regiment. He established a women's wing also. It was named as Jhansi Rani Regiment. Captain Lakshmi was its commander. Andaman Nicobar Islands, occupied by the Japan from British India. So with the support of Japan, so they came to Indian borders. They defeated British army and occupied here Andaman Nicobar. Then a decision, under the commandership of Shahnawaz Khan, reached here, Rangoon area, which is known as Burma. The Azad Hind Fauj with the 3,000 soldiers called as the Liberation Army. The Azad Hind Fauj along with the 3,000 soldiers as the Liberation Army started marching towards India and occupied Kohima in Assam. Here, they established here People's Rule. In first time, Azad Hind Fauj or INA established here People's Rule in India after occupying Kohima in Assam. So, it occupied next Moirang area near Imphal, and there they hoisted national flag also. By 1945, unfortunately, the British forces defeated INA and occupied Burma. So whatever, then onwards, you see, they occupied complete, so which were occupied by the INA, later British army also occupied the lands by the UN. So here you understand, Subhash Chandra Bose, the leader of INA or Azad Hind Fauj, he occupied the lands of here, Andaman, Nicobar, Assam, Nagaland, the eastern part, because Japan already marched towards the eastern part of India. That's what here Azad Hind Fauj also occupied same areas, but unfortunately, by 1945, Britishers defeated here Japan and INA forces also, because already in Second World War, you see, in the season 1942-43, already Japan, Germany, Italy, they were completely weakened. So that the army already could reach to India, so that they can easily occupy here they defeated here the forces of INA or Azad Hind Fauj. So, anyhow, unable to achieve its goal, but Azad Hind Fauj, INAR, even Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose gave a inspiration to many Indians, lakh of Indians, okay, with his valor, courage and self-confidence. Okay, he did not achieve, of course, its goal, complete freedom to India, but he gave great inspiration to many Indians even today also, because of his braver, valor, courage and self-confidence. And his all principles, of course, he inculcated patriotism, okay, especially, okay, among Indians. Okay, so afterwards, the war participated in, okay, in this supported INA, Azad Hind Fauj, okay, open trial conducted in Delhi. Here, they angered some people also, they arrested the Azad Hind Fauj force in India. Later, Japan announced the death of Netaji in 1945 in a plane crash. Okay, so because of plane crash, our leader, great leader Subhash Chandra Bose was, okay, passed away in 1945. Here, Japan government announced here in 1945 plane crash. So, in this, you understand, Subhash Chandra Bose also fought against the Britishers. One hand, Mahatma Gandhi, completely non-violent way, truth way, he started Satyagraha and made many movements in India. But other hand, when Subhash Chandra Bose completely, okay, did not believe here Mahatma Gandhi policies, that's what he took, okay, a different path, that is a forward black, established a radical party and started here fight against the Britishers. Here, he took the support of, okay, foreign nations also, but unfortunately, he was defeated and later, the Japan government here announced here the death of Netaji in 1945. With this, the great leader Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose is closed. So now moving to the cabinet mission, a topic. The Second World War exposed here Britain to a great extent because of the political, okay, and economically, politically, they were declined. So they decided to hand over the government to Indians. So that Britain sent a commission to India. The commission consists here, Petick Lawrence, Stanford Cripps, and A.V. Alexander. So they discussed here, detailed discussions conducted in India with the leaders of different political parties. So, this is called cabinet mission because these leaders or these members are cabinet members of England. So, that this mission is known as cabinet mission. After detailed discussion with many political leaders, they came to conclusion here. What are the proposals? Now, you understand. The first one, federal union for the whole India, including the princely states. Okay, India consists of, you know, native states, princely states, different states also. Of course, not only British rule, under the native rulers also, there are some areas are there, some states are there. That's what federal union, the whole India, including here mentioned here, princely states like Mysore, Hyderabad, Junagadh, Awadh, Kashmir, like that. These are in princely states. So, federal union for whole India. Full autonomy for provinces. Second one, full autonomy for provinces. Moving to third one, grouping our provinces into categories. Okay, the provinces into different categories. Now, next one, framing a constitution for India by the Constituent Assembly. Okay, framing of a constitution for India by the Constituent Assembly and Congress. These are the five resolutions were given by cabinet mission. INC, Congress and Muslim League accepted these proposals. Later, Muslim League rejected cabinet mission proposal. First accepted Congress and Muslim League. Later, the Muslim League rejected here cabinet mission proposal. Later, on September 2, 1946, interim government was formed with Jawaharlal Nehru as its leader. In 1946, remember the date? September 2, 1946, interim government was formed. British handed over all departments, including defense, to Indian government. This league, Muslim League, demanded here that central cabinet should have Muslim members selected by the league only. So, already here, the Indian government, interim government was formed. Here, Muslim League demanded here, the cabinet, central cabinet should consist of here, Muslim members. Okay, these members are selected by the only Muslim League only. That's what, when these were, it was rejected here, it was denied here, the league boycotted even Constituent Assembly also. So, when the differences were raised here, occurred here, and this during the Quit India movement also, Gandhiji, of course, along with many leaders, Gandhiji arrested. He was released in 1944. In this, Wavell was Viceroy of India. At that time, when he came to India, he tried to resolve the deadlock by stressing fundamental unity, because Indian National Congress accepted, approved the proposal of cabinet mission. Other side, Muslim League denied here. So that he tried to resolve the issue. That's what he came to India. He met Gandhiji, and the Muslim League also, Jinnah. Even Gandhiji also met Jinnah with definite proposals for finding a common solution, but Jinnah rejected them because they demanded a separate state for Muslims, that is Pakistan. That's what Jinnah rejected, the proposal of Gandhi, even Wavell also. Here, a plan of interim government, Viceroy's executive. Okay. First of all, a plan of interim government already we discussed, that is Jawaharlal Nehru as its leader, interim government, cabinet members are there. Okay. It consists of Indian members, but Muslim League rejected here. Viceroy's executive. Viceroy was the executive member. Here, all remaining members are Indians only. Viceroy, only a Britisher. Remaining major powers given to the Indians only. So, they conducted Simla conference to reach the unity between the Hindu Muslim League and INC. The Simla conference also conducted, but unfortunately, it did not come to a good result. Now, moving to the Mountbatten plan. Mountbatten was the last Governor General of India, British India, and first Governor General of Free India. You see here, there is two. One is Mountbatten. He was appointed as the Viceroy of India in place of Wavell in 1947. When Mountbatten planned here, he started a plan that is called June 3rd plan, or Mountbatten plan. It was named here June 3rd plan. He was ordered to complete the power transfer process in India by the Attlee government. Attlee was the Prime Minister of England after Second World War. So, Attlee declared here already given to the complete freedom to India, declared him. So that, according to that, Prime Minister or Cabinet of England sent here Mountbatten, to complete the power transfer process in India, by this government, of course. Mountbatten had talks with both the Congress and the Muslim League. He tried his best to create an understanding between the two. However, it was concluded that partition of the country was inevitable. Except. So, Muslim League demand is the only one, that is separate nation. That is complete a nation for Muslims, Pakistan, that is completely already from 1906 onwards, when Muslim League was established here, they followed here in 1939 onwards. They already, they said here number of times that is separate state for Muslims in Pakistan. Jinnah demanded from 1939 onwards. Now, in Mountbatten plan also you can see, he proposed here the partition of the country. So, Mountbatten plan here, the formation of Pakistan with the Muslim majority areas. So, consists of here Sindhu, Balochistan, northwest frontier provinces, okay, parts of here Punjab and Bengal. These are the areas, Muslim majority areas. So, formation of Pakistan with these areas only. And Congress had to accept the proposal in the view of deteriorating conditions of law and order. Okay, so law and order, because of law and order problem, because of the conditions were completely deteriorating, declining, so that INC as well as Gandhiji also approved finally for partition of the country, the India. So the partition of the country was inevitable, so that finally Gandhiji agreed for the partition of India. So Mountbatten later took steps according to the partition. So when the conditions completely deteriorating out of hand, land order problem, that's what they decided to divide India into two dominion countries. That is called India's Independence Act, July 1947. So Mountbatten plan, what is the Mountbatten plan here? Divide the country into two separate nations, two separate countries. So that one is India, another one is Pakistan. So before 1947, okay, they decided to divide here into two nations, into two nations, one is India, another one is Pakistan. That's what Indian Independence Act, July 1947, it was passed. On July 4th, 1947, the Independence Bill was introduced in British House of Commons. The bill was passed by the House of Commons on 15th July and the House of Lords the following day. That means 16th July. Okay. House of Lords and House of Commons. On July 15th, House of Commons passed here, and next one, House of Lords on the following day, that is 16th July, they passed here, they agreed here, and later the bill received here, okay. The bill was passed by the House of Commons on July 15th and the House of Lords the next day, that is July 16th. And the bill received here royal assent on 18th July 1947. So, this act provided for the partition of India and establishment of two dominion, okay, dominions of, that is India and Pakistan. Each dominion to have a governor general appointed by, okay, king of Britain. So, the legislatures of both dominions were empowered to make the laws for their dominions only. So, this is Indian Independence Act, July 1947. So, here the important dates here, July 15th and July 16th and July 18th. So, the jurisdiction of the British Parliament over India was to cease from 15th August 1947. So, 15th August 1947. The day onwards, the jurisdiction of the British Parliament over India was to cease. In accordance with the Act, on August 14, the Dominion of Pakistan was given. The accordance with the Act of August 14. So, August 14 was the date of, okay, Pakistan Day, Independence Day. August 15th, Day of India. So, here inaugurated the Pakistan, a new country, a new state, is a dominion, and joined here Jinnah, Muhammad Ali Jinnah became the Governor General. So, India became independent on 15th August 1947. Pakistan became independent on 14th August. Okay, it was created a new country, that is Pakistan, on 14th August, then onwards, remaining, okay, should be independent on 15th August 1947. So, Lord Mountbatten was sworn in as a Governor General, and Jawaharlal Nehru was sworn in as the first Prime Minister of Free India. So, Mountbatten was Governor General of Free India, first Governor General. Last Governor General of British India and first Governor General of Independent India. Next, Jawaharlal Nehru was sworn in as the first Prime Minister of Free India. So, this is the complete Indian Independence Act of 1947. So, with this, the chapter is completed. In this national movement, India's national struggle, national freedom fight, you see, the later phase, very important questions are there. The three movements of Mahatma Gandhi, non-cooperation, civil disobedience movement, and Quit India movement. Later, that important question about Subhash Chandra Bose also. Okay. Moving to the five more questions, round table conferences, Khilafat movement, Jallianwalabagh massacre, okay, Wavell plan, and even Indian Independence Act 1947. These are the very important questions in 5 marks. Moving to 2 marks, if you go to the early movements of Mahatma Gandhi, like Champaran Satyagraha, Simon Commission, Mountbatten plan, or June 3rd plan, these are the very important questions in very short questions. So, with this, the 15th chapter was finished. Okay. So far, in this later phase of India's national movement, we have covered here all movements of Mahatma Gandhi, revolutionary movements, and even Subhash Chandra Bose also. With this, the entire 15th chapter, national movement, was finished. Thank you.